Okay, I think we're ready to really test your knowledge of what we learned in this lesson. There are a lot of really awesome concepts that we've learned really in all the lessons up to this point, and we can start building an entire framework around how to understand particular traits. Let's use an example that combines the concepts of mutation, selection, and allelic frequency. The CCR5 gene is located on human chromosome 3, and it produces a protein, the CCR5 protein, that you can see here in green. And it resides on the surface of T cells. T cells are immune cells that fight infection. Now, although T cells do a pretty good job at fighting infection, in fact, they do an amazing job, really, there's a virus out there that can really take them out. It's called HIV, or the human immunodeficiency virus. You might have heard of it before. The HIV virus binds really well to this protein called CCR5. And when it does, the whole complex gets internalized. And this is how HIV gets inside T cells. It hijacks this protein and uses it to get inside the T cell, infect it, and then infect the entire immune system. So if you have a normally functioning CCR5 allele, then you're at risk for HIV infection. However, there's an allele of CCR5 that creates a very dysfunctional version of the protein, rendering it pretty much non-functional, and it can't even get to the cell surface of T cells. Without that CCR5 protein, the HIV simply can't get in the T cells. The T cells are thus resistant to HIV infection. So here's your first question using this example. Is the mutation for the dysfunctional protein that makes the T cell HIV resistant more likely in the coding or non-coding DNA of the genome? I want you to check one of these boxes and then explain why you think that's the answer in this text box here. I want you to save your answer, because guess what? You're going to need it in the next video.